Hey there, I'm Claudia St. John. I'm the president of Affinity HR Group. We are your HR partner and resource. I wanted to take a little time today to talk about severance agreements. So sometimes there are situations where you want to separate amicably and easily with an employee. Sometimes you want to separate with them and it's not their fault and you want to compensate them in some way because you want to make that transition as smooth as possible for them. In some instances, you're a little worried about that employee and you're worried that they may leave disgruntled and unhappy, and you want to figure out a way to make that a little bit of a better transition. Here's what we recommend when it comes to these. First of all, you need to have them performed by an attorney because they are legal documents that could be presented in a court of law and they should be treated as such. So you really don't want to download a separation agreement off of the internet. You want to make sure that they are going to withhold the test of time. Separation agreements usually have the following components. Usually you indicate why the individual is being separated from, or the fact that the individual is being separated. What benefits they will continue to get. So for example, will you continue with the medical benefits for that employee, or will they be eligible? Will they then roll over to COBRA? What happens to their accrued vacation? Things of that sort. There usually is also some sort of a payment. That's the benefit usually. And how is that payment spelled out? Are you going to continue to pay them for a certain period of time? Is it going to be a lump sum? How are you going to offer that payment? Then you have a section of the severance agreement that requests that the employee, as a result, as a quid pro quo of accepting the separation agreement, that they will waive their right to sue you for financial compensation under their rights under federal law. And that you can't prohibit somebody from suing you, but you can have them waive their rights to come to you for some sort of compensation as a result of what the reason why they would be inclined to sue you. Now, when you do that, you should definitely encourage them to have the severance agreement reviewed by their legal counsel. They should have 7 days with which to notify you as to whether or not they'll be accepting or rejecting the severance agreement, and then they have another 21 days after that to change their mind. So that's what's usually structured in a severance agreement. We recommend that they be used judiciously. For example, if you terminate all of the men in your organization and they get lovely separation severance agreements, and all of the women that get terminated don't get any, that's not good, because the courts look at your precedent, how you use them, what you offer. So be very mindful that you are setting a precedent every time you use a separation agreement. But do make sure that you have your attorney take a look at that, because you will have to require or recommend that the employee's attorney look at it. So yours probably should too. I hope that's helpful. I hope that you have a safe and productive work week. Take care.